Under one of my latest videos, I saw a very interesting comment. The topic was, how can you create a book in different languages and how to get those books up on Amazon through Amazon KDP, so publishing on different marketplaces. I thought that this topic could be very interesting to you self-publishers to get the most out of your existing book projects. I also used this method, this strategy to translate an existing high content book and publish it through Amazon KDP on different marketplaces. With this method, I was able to increase my royalties and my sales from 200 euros per month up to 2,200 euros per month. So it's not only a good idea to publish an existing book on different marketplaces. As I mentioned, I use the strategy myself, and besides that, it's not that difficult and expensive to publish your book on different marketplaces as you might think. So in today's video, I want to show you exactly everything you have to know to translate your book in different languages and publish those books through Amazon KDP on different marketplaces and get even more out of your already existing book projects. Hi, my name is Matthew. Welcome or welcome back on my YouTube channel, where I talk about self-publishing through Amazon KDP on Amazon and help you to earn money online. If you haven't done yet, please feel free to subscribe to the channel. As you can see, we are so close to almost 1,000 subscribers. If you like the video, put a thumbs up on it. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section down below. Of course, before you can start uploading your translated book onto different marketplaces, you need to prepare a few things at first. So let's do a little example here. You have an existing book in the language of English and you want to translate this book in, for example, France. Okay, and so publish this book on the French marketplace Amazon.fr. Of course, you have to translate your title and your subtitle from English into French. After this, you have to translate your product description or your book description also in France. And very obviously, you have to translate the whole content of your interior from English into French too. So a big pack of translation at first. Besides that, you need, of course, keywords for the 7 keyword boxes that are relevant on the French marketplace, because you want to rank for those French keywords exactly in the same way like you are ranking for keywords on the American marketplace in English. Okay, so you need to do an extended keyword research for the French marketplace. After you have translated your title, your subtitle, and optional, the product description on the back cover, you need to go to your cover designer. Ask your cover designer if he or she can recreate your already existing cover with the new title and the new subtitle to give you the new recreated cover for your new translated book. So how you can do the first part, translate your title, subtitle, product description, and the content of your interior from, for example, English into French. As you can see on the screen right now, we are at first at the tool from deepl.com. It's linked in the video description. So DeepL is a very good translation tool where you can copy and paste your existing language or existing text, for example, in English, and the tool will translate it directly into your new language, for example, France. So as you can see, we are now at the tool and, for example, we have a title and subtitle for our English book, How to Learn English, A Beginner's Guide. And as you can see, you are typing in or copy and pasting in your title and subtitle, and the tool will automatically translate it into France, as you can see it on the right box. Okay, what you need to do, you have to select the new language. Okay, you can see you can select a few options here. For example, you can translate it in Spanish, Portuguese, German, English, and France, okay? And now what you have to do, you can copy and paste in your title in this left box. You can copy and paste your product description and parts of your high content texts into this left box, and the tool will automatically translate it. You can copy the translated text that appears on the right box into your Word document, your Word file, or your PDF file, okay? I have to say the tool is very, very good, but it can't replace a native speaker. This is very important. The tool is good, but a native speaker or a native reader will notice the difference between a translation from an IE, from a tool, compared to a translation from a native speaker. So I would recommend to use Fiverr, searching for professional proofreaders that are native speaker in your goal language. So what you can do, you can go on Fiverr, it's linked down in the video description, and then typing in translate from English into France, okay? And then many of freelancers appear on the first page. You can select the seller details, and you can select the language, the native language of the freelancer. So I would highly recommend to you guys to do this. So you can select, for example, France, select the filter, and then you have here native speakers that will translate the existing book into France. So as I mentioned, Fiverr, it's linked in the video description. So now we have a translated title and subtitle. We translated through Fiverr or through DeepL our product description and the whole content of our interior, for example, of a high content book or a medium low content book. Okay, so now the next thing is we need a new, not exactly new, a recreation of our existing cover. Of course, if you are doing the cover design on your own, it's not a big problem. You have your translated title and subtitle, replace the English version into the French version, and then you're ready to go. But if you have a designer that created the first cover design for you, contact the designer, ask him kindly if he can recreate the existing cover for a very good and cheap price. And in the most cases, the cover designer will do the work for you, because he don't have to create a new design. The only thing he has to do is replace the title and subtitle with the new translated version. So again, you can use Fiverr or Upwork to search for good cover designers. So now we are almost done. We have most of the work done. The last thing is we need 7 keywords for our keyword boxes in the uploading process. So what you can do to generate high performing keywords on another marketplace. I'm sure all of you guys know that I am a huge fan of PublisherRocket, but PublisherRocket is limited in the keyword research on different marketplaces. As you can see, at the moment at PublisherRocket are only the US market, the United King market, and the German marketplace available for keyword research. The first thing I can always recommend is to go to your target marketplace. So we want to publish a book in France. So we can go on Amazon.fr. You can see it on the screen. Then you can select the category of books. So it's called Livre on French. And then you can do your research like you would do it on the American marketplace. Start typing in different keywords, different phrases, and have a closer look what Amazon suggests you. And you can use those suggestions for your 7 keyword boxes. Another thing you can do your keyword research for another marketplace is Helium 10. I know Helium 10 is a little bit expensive. It costs you around about between $40 and $90 per month. But you can do a very high quality keyword research for every available marketplace. So for example, we can use the tool Magnets. It is a keyword research tool. You can see all the marketplaces you can select and do a keyword research for it. French marketplace, Amazon FR, and Again, we can typing in or pasting in our main keyword, and then we can click on Get Keywords, and Helium 10 will show us all the recommendations, all the keywords that are relevant to your search term. And with Helium 10, you have the chance or the opportunity to select high performing keywords for your new translated book, fill in the 7 keyword boxes, and publish a book on the French marketplace, for example. Now, we are prepared to upload and publish our new translated book. We are creating a paperback version, so we are clicking on Create Paperback. And now, the first important thing, you have to select the language your book will be published in. So you are selecting French, okay? Then it's the same procedure like publishing on the American marketplace. You are typing in the title, the subtitle, your author name, of course, your product description that you have translated through Fiverr or DeepL, and your 7 keyword boxes that you researched on the Amazon search bar or on Helium 10. Then on the second page, again, get your free ISBN directly from Amazon, choose the paper and the color options, choose the size of your book, if you are using bleed or no bleed, and if the cover of your paperback is matte or glossy. Those options are the same like your previous, the American version, so you can just copy those sections, those settings, and then you are continuing with uploading your paperback manuscript, so the interior of your high, medium or low content file, and you're uploading your recreated cover design. On the last page, you making the selection of your price, and very important, as you can see, you have to choose your primary marketplace. In the most cases, you self-publishers publishing on Amazon.com, but now you have selected that you are publishing a book in French, and on the third page, Amazon automatically chooses the primary marketplace, Amazon.fr. If this is not the case, you have to select your primary marketplace, Amazon.fr. Then again, you have to choose your price, and after this, you can publish your paperback book. Congratulations, you translated and published an existing book on a different marketplace. As I mentioned, it's not that difficult. You have to prepare a few things at first. If you have the work done, the uploading process is exactly the same like on any other marketplace. And now you have recreated an existing book, translated it, and published it on another marketplace. Before we end the video here, let me show you real quick a few things that are very important that can cause you a few problems. There are a few things that you have to keep in mind, that you have to know before you do the work, translate your book in another language and want to publish it on a different marketplaces. Not everything or every option is available for every marketplace. This is the first and very important thing that you have to know. Let's start with the first point, paperback versus hardcover. When you are publishing a paperback book, you can select most of the existing Amazon marketplace. But if you want to combine it with publishing a hardcover version of your paperback book, it causes you a little problem. If you're publishing a paperback version, you can see you can select the primary marketplaces as shown in the screen. So we have 12 primary marketplaces available for the paperback version. If we compare it to the hardcover version, you can see that you have only 9 primary marketplaces available. But as you can see, for example, you cannot publish a hardcover book on the Australian marketplace or on the Canadian marketplace. So always keep this in mind if you want to publish a hardcover version of your paperback book. You cannot select every available marketplace. So this is problem number one. The next problem that you have to know is A+ content. Of course, you need to publish or create A+ content to get the best performance on your book, on your listing, and get a few steps in front of your competition and have a professional book listing that sells very well. So if we are at the marketing section and have a closer look on the box of A+ content, you can see that you can only choose A+ content for those selectable marketplaces. So always keep this in mind, not every marketplace is available for A+ content. The next problem, and in my opinion, the biggest problem, is Amazon advertising. There are just a few marketplaces available for Amazon advertising. And without Amazon advertising, you're not performing as high as you want to and don't make those amount of money and royalties that you want to achieve. So again, in the marketing section, you can see Amazon ads are only available for those few marketplaces. So always keep this in mind. If you, for example, want to publish a book in Japanese on the Amazon marketplace of Japan, you can create the book in Japanese, upload it on Amazon Japan, but you cannot run ads for it because Amazon Japan is not available for Amazon advertising. Always keep this in mind before you create or translate a book and publish it on your targeted marketplace. First, check out if you can run ads for it. The last problem is the offer central page. As you know, you can create offer central pages to show customers different books that you have created and uploaded and give a potential buyer the chance to browse through your library and earn those few extra sales. But as you can see, not all of the available marketplaces can be selected to create an offer central page. So always keep this again in mind if you are translating and publishing book through Amazon KDP. In the first step, check all the problems. Can you create Amazon advertising? Can you create an offer central page? Can you create A+ content on your selected marketplace? If yes, give it a try, translate your book, publish your book. If not, always keep in mind, are you really sure publish or translate and put the work into your book project? Is it worth it or not? Always keep these problems in mind. So guys, we are now at the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I hope the informations in this video help you or helping you to translate and publish your first book on another marketplace. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section down below. And if you haven't done yet, feel free to subscribe to the channel. I wish you a very good day, and we will see you in the next video.